In this video, we're going to talk about kinetic particle theory. It's about the three different states of matter. We'll look at the properties for each of the states and how they change from one state to another. The three states of matter are solid, liquid, and gas. The particles in solid states are packed closely together. They are arranged in an orderly manner right next to each other. Because of that, solid has fixed shape and fixed volume. That means when solid is placed in a container, it will not take on the shape of the container. Instead, it will retain its own shape and volume. Since the particles are so closely packed, that's why solid can't be compressed. Next, we move on to the second state of matter, which is liquid. Liquid's particles are loosely packed compared to solid. That's why they do not have a fixed shape and it takes on the shape of the container. However, since liquid has fixed volume, that means it will only fill up the container up to the volume of the liquid. Let's say we have a 500 ml beaker and we pour 100 ml liquid. What happens is the liquid is going to start filling up from the bottom. It's going to take on the shape of the beaker, but it will stop at 100 ml. That's what it means by liquid having no fixed shape but fixed volume. Since liquid's particles are close together, even though they are not as close as the particles in solid, it's still difficult to compress them. The third state of matter is gas. Gas particles are constantly in motion, and because of that, they don't have any fixed shape and volume. Take iodine gas, for example, it's purple in color. When you place a little bit of iodine gas inside a closed container, say like 500 ml container, in time, the entire container is going to be filled with purple gas. That's because the gas particles are constantly in motion and they're far apart from one another. Since the distance between the gas particles is large, that makes it possible to compress them. Now that we know about the three states of matter, let's see what happens when heat is added to one of the states. When heat is added to solid and is absorbed by the solid particles will undergo melting to become liquid. This is like when we have ice and we expose it to heat, the ice particle will absorb the heat and then it will melt to become liquid, which is water. And if we heat up liquid long enough, it will undergo evaporation to become gas, that is like heating water, and then it becomes water vapor. Now, if solid absorbs heat and is transformed into gas directly, that process is called sublimation. It's like when we have iodine solid and we heat it up, it becomes purple gas directly without going through the liquid phase. That's sublimation. Now, if we do the reverse, where heat is released, and when gas particles release heat to the surrounding, the gas particles will undergo condensation to become liquid. That's like trapping water vapor and condensing it, and we get liquid water. And when liquid particles release heat to become solid, that's called freezing. That's like taking water, putting it in the freezer, and it releases heat to the surrounding, and it becomes solid ice. If gas transition directly to solid state, that's called deposition. An example of that is trapping the iodine gas and cooling it down, and it will turn into solid directly without going through the liquid phase. That's deposition. With that, we've gone through the properties of solid, liquid, and gas, and the changes they undergo when absorbing or releasing heat. Here are two more videos that might interest you. Thanks for watching all the way to the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share with someone. Don't forget to subscribe. Your support means a lot to me.